This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
In Eye to Eye today, we are joined by Mr. Ramakrishna Hegde, president of the Lok Shakti, who was instrumental in bringing the Janata Dal United into an electoral alliance with the BJP. Mr. Hegde, there were some heart-stopping moments there in this hurriedly convened marriage, though.
It is true that for some time we had to face difference of opinion among these three or four parties, particularly between the BJP and the other three parties. But this is not a sudden development. You know, for the last 6 or 7 months, the parties which were part of the alliance had been meeting to bring about greater coordination and understanding between themselves. You know, my idea in forming this group, along with George Fernandez, is to reduce the number of parties in the alliance, you know, which will promote greater understanding and which will also prevent the possibility of defection.
But Mr. Hegde, there was an impression, there was a perception that the bride and the groom was brought to the mantap kicking and screaming. You had a difficult time playing the pujari, didn't you?
Well, the bride and the groom were not totally strangers. There was an alliance before, you know, when we formed Janata Party in 1977, you know, after the emergency. You know, all the leaders belonging to these three, four parties were in jail together. And at that time, you see, we thought of bringing all these parties together, merging into one, so that we can fight the emergency and the dictatorship of Mrs. Gandhi. And therefore, Bharatiya Janata Party was a part of Janata Party. And actually, it was called Jansangh at that time.
But Mr. Hegde, that is all part of history now. In this particular alliance that you tried to bring together, the BJP seemed to feel that you were arm-twisting them, particularly with that press note which emerged from the Lok Shakti office here. It was like a bombshell which said, accept this alliance or else.
Well, there are certain elements even in Bharatiya Janata Party which are opposed to the idea of these three parties coming together. They think, I think it is the misconception, that if we come together, we'll become stronger, and then we'll provide, perhaps we'll pose a problem, you know, to the alliance. It is not so. And it is with the view of strengthening the Prime Minister's hand and strengthening the alliance.
Is it true that Mr. Vajpayee supported your move and that the Home Minister, Mr. Advani, was opposed to this alliance?
No, both of them supported the move. Vajpayee openly said, and Sri Advani did not say so openly, but he was not against this move. And you must have noticed that, you know, in Ballari, he openly said that, you know, this alliance, you know, has brought greater strength to the National Democratic Alliance.
Why is the BJP in Karnataka so wary of you? Is it because of your grassroots support, your stature in Karnataka? Is it because they don't have a leader of your stature and they feel that you may start dominating the proceedings if you get the lion's share of the votes?
Well, you know, I really don't know. This question should be asked to the BJP leaders of the state. And if they have such an idea, it is totally misplaced. You know, whatever I want to do is to build up this understanding. And perhaps, you know, they fail to understand it.
What would happen if your alliance won the election, swept the assembly polls here? Who would be chief minister? Your party has already said they want you as chief minister. BJP has indicated in so many words that, no, they want Yedurappa. What's going to happen post-elections?
There is not going to be a fight over leadership. You know, I had been chief minister twice over, and both the times I was the unanimous choice. I never angled for this. The natural course will follow after the election. If you get majority, we are sure to get majority. The members of the legislature party will elect the new leader in a democratic manner.